Chemistry 20. This is our fifth lesson in the Solutions unit. This is Solubility and Equilibrium. In this lesson, we will explore solutions and solubility, saturation, factors affecting solubility, dynamic equilibrium, and we'll work through three examples. Solutions and solubility. If you're looking for more information regarding these topics, you can watch the crash course video on the link provided below. Solubility. Solubility is the maximum amount of solute that can be dissolved in a solvent, typically water, at a specific temperature and/or a pressure for gases. This means that solubility is affected by the temperature. The units of solubility are moles per liter, or more commonly, grams per 100 milliliters. Every pure substance has its own unique solubility in different solvents. In this lesson, we will only focus on the solvent of water. For example, the solubility of sodium chloride in water is 36 grams in 100 milliliters at 20 degrees Celsius. If the temperature were to change, so would the solubility of sodium chloride. When solutes dissolve in solvents, they are not reacting. Solute particles mix evenly with solvent particles. Saturation. Saturated solutions have a maximum amount of solute dissolved at a given temperature, meaning if you were to add more solute to the solution, it would not dissolve. Unsaturated solutions have less than the maximum amount of solute dissolved at a given temperature, meaning if you were to add more solute to the solution, it would dissolve. And finally, we have supersaturated solutions, which contain more dissolved solute than normally possible at a given temperature. These supersaturated solutions are formed by heating, then carefully cooling a solution. Factors affecting solubility. As temperature increases, the solubility of solids and liquids increases. This is because the kinetic energy of all particles in the solution have increased, meaning they're moving faster and have a greater ability to interact. As temperature increases, the solubility of gases in liquid solutions decreases. As temperature increases, intermolecular forces between the gas particles and solvent particles are broken, allowing the gas to escape from solution. As pressure increases, the solubility of liquids and solids does not change. As pressure increases, the solubility of gases in gaseous or liquid solutions increases. This is because as pressure increases, gases become compressed and are smaller, and are then able to dissolve more in a solution. The other factor affecting solubility is polarity. And remember, like dissolves like. Polar solutes dissolve in polar solvents. Solubility equilibrium. Equilibrium occurs when the forward rate of reaction is equal to the reverse rate of reaction. If we look at our example chemical equation, we can see a double arrow. This represents an equilibrium. On the forward reaction, which goes from left to right, we have the solid NaCl dissolving into its ions. In the reverse reaction, which goes from right to left, we have the ions Na plus and Cl minus recrystallizing to form the solid NaCl. Both the forward and reverse reaction are occurring at the exact same time. This is known as an equilibrium reaction. The dissolving forward reaction rate is equal to the recrystallization reverse reaction rate. This only occurs in saturated solutions. If the solution was not saturated, we would not have the reactants, a solid NaCl. Therefore, we would not have a forward reaction. Example number one. A 20.0 milliliter sample of saturated solution of potassium nitrate at 25 degrees Celsius was evaporated to produce 7.2 grams of dry solid residue. What is the solubility of potassium nitrate in grams per 100 milliliters? Pause the video and attempt this example. We know that 7.2 grams of potassium nitrate can be dissolved in 20 milliliters of solution, which equals 0.36 grams can be dissolved per 1 milliliter of solution. We can then simply times this value by 100 to get the solubility of potassium nitrate, which is 36 grams per 100 milliliters at 25 degrees Celsius. Example number two. The solubility of aluminum fluoride is 0.559 grams per 100 milliliters at 25 degrees Celsius. Is it possible to dissolve 3.0 grams of solid to make 500 milliliters of solution at 25 degrees Celsius? What type of solution would this be? Saturated or unsaturated? Pause the video and attempt this example. We know that the solution can hold 0.559 grams per 100 milliliters. If we were to divide this value by 100, we would be left with 0.00559 grams of aluminum fluoride can dissolve in 1 milliliter. We can then take the solution, which has 3.0 grams of aluminum fluoride per 500 milliliters, and we can get a value of 0.006 grams per 1 milliliter. As a result, this value is larger than the actual amount of aluminum fluoride that can be dissolved. Therefore, no, 3.0 grams of aluminum fluoride will not dissolve in 500 milliliters of water. This would be a saturated solution. Example number three. How does the solubility of CO2 gas in water vary with an increase in pressure of CO2 gas and an increase in water temperature? Pause the video and attempt this example. Increasing the pressure causes the solubility of gases in liquid solutions to increase. And increasing the temperature causes the solubility of gases in liquid solutions to decrease. Moving forward, we will explore the concept of net ionic equations.